My message to them is, man, we're close. You know, obviously we've got to play more consistently on third down. It was obvious on both sides that that's kind of where the game was decided in the fourth quarter. But I want our kids to take great confidence. I want it to sting that we lost a game that we had a chance to win against a very good football team. But at the same time, you know, continue to build on the good things that we did do.
I want to ask for this third down.
Yeah, we've got to have a better third down plan. And some of the time you give credit to the defense. They won. You know, they're national champions 2 years in a row, and they beat you in a one-on-one. But I think our plan could have been better. I'm always the hardest critic on myself and the staff if I think we could have done some more things. And I do think we had better options on those critical third downs. And we've got to make sure that the ball is touching our best players' hands. And then they have to execute it, obviously. The one fourth down one, we had a really high snap that our back never got on track. And those things happen sometimes, too. But I do think our plan needs to be better.
Coach, a lofty question here. But with the ever-changing landscape of college football, just what do you personally hope to see with, you know, kind of keeping the sanctity of the sport alive and the traditions that people love when I think there's a lot of fear?
Well, I mean, the game has changed, and I don't know that we coaches have the power to do anything to really slow the changes down. And obviously the conference realignment has happened within our conference, and I'm pretty confident that the SEC is pretty solid on where we are, and I think they'll enjoy the new rivalries when they get to see Texas and Oklahoma and among the great rivalries that we already have in our conference. And you know, I'll miss playing Georgia every year because I just got to experience it for my first time, and you know, I loved every minute of it other than the outcome. I love competing against those type teams, and so there are some changes coming. And obviously with the NIL world and the transfer portal, we've got to accept those, and some of it's good, some of it probably needs to be changed some, but I'm not sure where it's headed or how we corral it and make the necessary changes. So, you know, let's do the best with the current status that we have, and still enjoy what I think is the greatest sport and greatest I just don't think there's a greater sport than college football. Not totally, but there were some positives for sure that I think we can build upon. And again, like I've said in many press conferences, coaches get blamed, quarterbacks get blamed. Coaches probably deserve it more so than the quarterbacks sometimes, because it's a lot of pieces that go together to make sure the quarterback looks good. And sometimes it's the protection, sometimes it's the routes, and sometimes it's the quarterback that caused it. And there was a combination of all of that that we can improve on, but I did see some solid things also. We're about midpoint, so I guess if you had an ideal date that you could set, it would probably be for me like after game seven. But this is not a bad time. We certainly need it. We're beat up and got a lot of kids that have, you know, injuries that are kind of causing them either to be out or to not be 100%. And hopefully we can get a lot of those close to 100 by the time we go to LSU.
You had a few home games this year against UMass and things like that, but where the atmosphere was turned up against Georgia. I know you've coached against Auburn. What's it like to have that crowd at your back and use that as an advantage when you play a really good team like Georgia?
I think we have the best atmosphere in college football at Jordan-Hare. And they proved that Saturday again, and I thought they were incredible. I thought they gave us help, and it's a great advantage to play at home in these conference games. And a lot of stadiums have that, and I think we're right at the top. We should be mentioned with the best in the country because our fans are that way.
Coach, when you're building the confidence of your quarterbacks, and there's obviously, you know, some growing pains, getting getting everyone comfortable. What's your message to them to try to build that confidence and shake off, you know, some of these games that they may have?
Yeah, play the next play. And, you know, you've got to be accountable to the things you should have done correctly, and I've got to be accountable if I didn't coach you well enough, as do our coaches. But play the next play, and let's get ready for the next week and try not to make the same mistakes. And that's real life. And quarterback play, receiver play, all of that is about, man, looking what's on the film, and we've got to own it. And we've got to get better from that from week to week. And I love the approach that both Peyton and Robbie have had, and their attitude is good. Of course, they all want the job and want to play, and they both did some good things Saturday, and they both did some things that, in particular, Peyton, that he probably could correct, and we've got to get those corrected moving forward.
I want to ask you the passing game. After you had a chance to look at the film from Saturday, I know you mentioned you wanted to take a look at it. What are your thoughts about the elements around Peyton, not him specifically, but how to improve?
Yeah, all facets of it need to improve. The protection, the routes. I thought he had 6 drops, truthfully, after watching the film, that could have easily been caught. There were balls thrown in the right place, and give their defensive backs some credit sometimes for good punch outs, but our guys have to finish those plays to help our quarterback also. And there were a few protections that he set wrong that caused us negative plays, and you've got to take it all in and then go back to work and try to get it corrected. But there were some steps in the right direction in the passing game. We didn't complete them all, but they were thrown to the right spot, our receivers were in the right spot, and we just didn't make the play.
Coach, this is a very special club you're speaking to today. They have a $2 million campaign that goes to charities. Tell us a little bit about speaking to this club today.
Well, you know, anytime people in our position can do something for needy children, you know, my wife and I are all in on that. And I've been familiar with the Birmingham Quarterback Club, and they're probably – I don't want to make others mad, but they're probably the best in the nation at really putting their money where their mouth is and supporting needy children. So it's an honor that I can play a small role in that.
Coach, I wanted to ask you if you could put yourself in the shoes of your players. Obviously, in this day and age, there's so much pressure from social media. Obviously, you probably feel as a head coach too, but what's your message to them to deal with that pressure and that negative noise that they hear on such an extreme level these days?
I teach a class every Monday to our team and every Thursday, but in every one of those classes, I talk about the addiction to cell phones and to social media, and it's something that I think all of us have battled with it at one time or another, and I think it's an awful addiction. And truthfully, I say that because the problem is they start getting their identity from something other than what the truth is. And their identity is not caught up in what people say of you or what you do or what you have. It's really who you are as a man. And I think we work very hard on that, but it's still an uphill battle because the addiction to social media and the things that are on cell phones is real.
Thank you guys so much.
Yep.